A recent study found over half of Gen Z Filipinos are picking up multiple jobs. Andrea Taguines tells us why.
Hustle now, retire early. That's the main takeaway in a new study released by Philippine healthcare provider PhilCare. The study shows the Filipino Gen Z, or those born between 1997 and 2015, prefer getting as many gigs or sidelines as they can early on in their career to allow them to retire young. That's in contrast to how older generations prepare for retirement, which is by working in a traditional office setting while keeping their eyes peeled for potential business ventures in the long run. 53% of Gen Z said they prefer multiple part-time jobs over just one full-time work, compared to just 48% of Generations X and Y, or the so-called millennials. According to the lead researcher of the PhilCare Wellness Index, this can be attributed to several factors. For one, more Gen Z respondents said they feel the double burden of supporting themselves and their parents compared to the non-Gen Z.
Kung sino ang single, siya ang may, o pinaka-nakababata, siya yung may responsibility sa magulang. Kasi nga, may nuclear family na yung older. Ang priority nila, yung sarili nilang pamilya. If you feel the double burden, ang ginagawa nga ng mga Gen Z ngayon ay rumakit.
More Gen Z also want to set aside additional funds for leisure and actually make time for such recreational activities like traveling by going for jobs that have flexible work hours. Another distinction is that more Gen Z want to work abroad, while the mindset of older generations is to stay in the Philippines or return home if they have been working overseas.
Nakikita nila na kasinggaling naman sila nung sa ibang bansa, but hindi sila kapareho ng bayad. Kung ito yung kakayahan ko at nakikita ko yung mga kasabayan ko ay pareho naman kaming ginagawa, ba't ako magstay dito?
But will this automatically translate to a mass migration? Not necessarily.
Nawawala na rin yung tinatawag na parang territoriality. Working abroad doesn't mean working abroad. Daming mga working students namin who are actually working abroad in the sense that they maintain social media accounts of restaurants in the U.S.
Meanwhile, one similarity that the study found among Gen X, Gen Y, and Gen Z is that they now put a higher premium on health benefits, which is likely a lesson learned from the COVID-19 pandemic. Paraga said this clamor for health benefits could also mean that there are still many Filipinos who are not insured. PhilCare Wellness Index Chairman Dr. Enrique Ona hopes the results of the study could lead to better policies and workplace arrangements for all generations of workers.
The government needs to create straightforward, effective programs that support an aging population, ensuring that they have safety nets and viable options to continue contributing to our economy if they so desire. Meanwhile, the private sector must stay attuned to the shifts in work culture, particularly the importance of work-life balance and personal time that are emphasized by the younger generations.
800 respondents nationwide were surveyed for the latest PhilCare Wellness Index. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
British bank HSBC interested in expanding its investments in the Philippines. This was communicated by its chairman, Mark Tucker, during a courtesy call to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in Malacanang Thursday. He also expressed the bank's commitment to support the Philippine government's economic agenda, adding HSBC is keen on exploring opportunities to strengthen partnership with the government. HSBC has been operating in the Philippines for almost 150 years and is the second largest foreign bank in the country. A global securities watchdog is calling for closer scrutiny of stock exchanges. The International Organization of Securities Commission says market evolutions have changed the way exchanges and exchange groups are operating, which can potentially create new conflicts of interest, as well as operational and organizational interdependencies. It proposes six practices for regulators to assess how exchanges are structured and monitored. Among the market evolutions it cited, increased cross-border operations due to Brexit and more exchanges becoming publicly listed companies. Happy ending for Walt Disney CEO Bob Iger and other board members as they survive a battle against activist investors. Here's the full story.
Walt Disney shareholders have backed Chief Executive Bob Iger and other company directors, defeating a campaign by activist investors who argued the entertainment giant has underperformed in the streaming television era. Wednesday's vote to re-elect all 12 of Disney's current board members ended the year's most expensive and closely watched boardroom fight. It was launched by billionaire Nelson Peltz and Blackwell's Capital, who were seeking 5 seats between them on Disney's board. With that battle over, Disney's hunt for a successor to Iger kicks into high gear. The board has extended his retirement 5 times, and his new date is by the end of 2026. Members sought to reassure shareholders ahead of Wednesday's vote that they now take the matter seriously and are vetting candidates. Iger, meanwhile, has a window to execute a recovery, analysts say, by making the streaming television unit profitable and launching an app for Disney's flagship ESPN Sports Network. Iger said with the, quote, distracting proxy contest now behind Disney, it would focus on growth and value creation as well as creative excellence. Peltz's and Blackwell's bids were separate and competing, but both argued the $225 billion media company has bungled its CEO succession plans, lost its creative spark, and failed to properly harness new technology.